Meanwhile, there's a bill sitting on the governor's desk that aims to create a council that would give women and children a greater voice in crafting state laws that impact them.
Joining us now is Kina Collins, Chairwoman of the Illinois Council for Women and Children. Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for having me.
So can you give us some specific examples of, let's say, legislation or policy that you said, you know what, if they had had women in that conversation, things would be a lot different. Can you give us some examples of the problem?
Yes, I definitely do. I think that not even just here in the state of Illinois, but across the country, we are seeing a lot of policy and legislation being written where women and girls' voices are not included at the table. A lot of points of contention for some bills here in Illinois were like HB 40, which dealt with health care. And then, of course, we just talked about ERA. I have my ERA pen today. So I think that having women's voices and girls' voices at the table gives it a holistic perspective.
Going forward, is there a specific policy that you want to try to focus on, assuming Governor Rauner signs this?
Absolutely. So we have 9 impact areas that we will be working on, which include things like education, healthcare, childcare. It runs the gamut, STEAM. How do we inject these areas with more women and girls? But in the same time, you know, no specific policies, just the ones that come up that would impact us.
There are female legislators in the state and federal level.
Absolutely.
I mean, why not just rely on them to fight the good fight?
Well, I think it's two-pronged, right? So what our council would specifically do is not just analyze policy, but we would also have a programmatic piece. So you have women and girls all across the state of Illinois who they don't get a chance to sit with the governor, right, every day and lawmakers, but they're in their communities, they're doing the work. How do we pull them in as well? And I think that that's what the council would be really great at.
When you look at the panel of women that you want to create, obviously women, and we saw this from the election, are not a monolithic group. There's
exactly.
A lot of diversity of opinion within the female group. How do you make sure that you have all those voices counted in a discussion?
So a lot of what we've been doing, we've been building out this council and the infrastructure of the council for about 9 or 10 months since last summer. Mm-hmm. And essentially we've been going to about 68 out of the 102 counties in the state of Illinois, and we've been hosting focus groups, right? And in these focus groups, we have asked women, we've tapped into community organizations, nonprofits, for-profits, and lawmakers, bringing everybody to the table to say, what should this council look like? And so that has given us a breadth of what we should expect with the council.
I would imagine most policy impacts women in some way or another.
Absolutely.
Is the message here that you men don't get it?
Absolutely not.
why can't they do the job that you're asking them to do?
Well, I think that it's the same reason why we still have pay wage equity gaps, right? Mm-hmm. There's a lot of great policy that is written. Unfortunately, we need a culture shift, right? So we don't want this council to just serve as a policy or political talking point. We want it to be an education and a cultural piece, right? And the way that you do that is by building allyship, not just with giving great ideas with a ton of women sitting around the table, but bringing men to the table to ask them, are you willing to do diversity and inclusion trainings in your corporations or in your organizations to teach about issues that women deal with, right? So I think it's a cultural shift that we're aiming for.
Did you find a lot of support in Springfield, or did you get some pushback from legislators?
We got a ton of support. I think that people know that it's time that we bring women and girls to the table in a holistic way. And I think that even the people who had a bit of concerns after a while and they got to speak to a few of the other women, they realized this is a really great idea. So it passed through the House and it passed through the Senate, and it's on the governor's desk.
All right. Kina Collins, thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much.
Nice meeting you.